And welcome back to what should be the final part of this flying sub build. So essentially all I've got to do is this front part. It all needs repainting. So I'm going to start by, if we're coming close, around by these lights, I'm going to get all this cleaned up nice again. We're going to get all this edging, top and bottom, masked really close, then go in on these edges as well, all masked in, and spray the whole thing. Oh, gonna make sure that we get a bit of mask all into the LEDs on these lights to protect them. I think I'm gonna use the Tamiya aluminium or silver because they're a bit duller, and then go back in with the Vallejo chrome over these bits. So I'm gonna get it cleaned up to where I need it to be, masked up, and we'll have a look before we start putting the paint on. Probably get a better idea then. Right, so this has taken a while to get it masked properly, but this is now masked right up to this rim, top and bottom. Carefully just applied mask all over the LED, masked off the vents. So I'm going to hit this front now, I think, with the aluminium first. Then we'll remove these masks to touch up the chrome. Then we've got the blue stripe to put in. This front window, around it, and from the two stripes top and bottom meet up as well over the corner of the window. So I'm going to get some paint down and we will have another look at things. Right, so just thought I'd show a bit of progress. Got the aluminium down. This has had a flat coat as well, because I don't want it too shiny, because it's got a bit chrome, so I want that to stand out. Got this side masked up, ready for the blue. So it'll extend the stripes all the way down, cross, round the window, and we've got part of the window's going to be protected to still have the aluminium on. So that should look quite cool when we take all the masks off. I'll get this second side masked up the same. We'll get the blue down. I think I'll put a gloss coat over that, so of the semi-gloss coat, the same as we've had previously, because I think that'll look, so it all makes it look similar. Let that dry. We'll get the mask peeled off, the chrome on, and we'll see how all this front's looking. Right, so blue's all down now, glossed over. I've pulled off the masks to this side, because next thing I need to do is just touch up the chrome on the bars above the LEDs for the headlights and on these vents. And then it'll be my favourite part of this process, pulling off all this masking and seeing how it looks. So that is what we will all see next. Okay, so I have finally got all the masks removed. Got some touching up paint to do around the windows. Gonna do all this with a brush. Not gonna remask it. Need to polish the windows up a little bit. That's not a major issue. And Gonna have to decant some of our yellow paint, because some of these stripes aren't as neat as I wanted, so gonna have to neaten them up. Need to give it a good clean, because there's a bit of residual stickiness from some of the masking tape. I've had a really bad bleed of colour down there, so that's going to need to be touched up. So most of today is going to be just touching up all the paintwork. Going to get some of our Tamiya yellow decanted out so we can do all this through the airbrush and paintbrush. So probably next time you see this, will actually be all the paint touched up and the model finished. So I'm going to have a fun day with lots of painting. Right, so everything is finished now. Let's try to get lighting a bit better. There we can see inside. It's on its base. I'm actually surprised how sturdy this is on the base. All paint jobs touched up, really happy with it. Can see loads of lights inside. Really happy with how I did this, how I calmed it down so it wasn't mental like a disco. Can see the bed. Other panels. So I'm really pleased with this. Really, really enjoyed this build. Might go back at some point and touch this bit up. It's not 100% accurate, but I can live with how it is. It's like only when you get really close you can notice it. So I'm going to take some photos. And we'll have a look at the photos at the end. But for this time, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed my build. Keep trekking and keep modelling. Thank you. Goodbye.
The Sea View, the most extraordinary submarine in all the seven seas. Its public image is that of an instrument of marine research. In actuality, it is the mightiest weapon afloat and is secretly assigned to the most dangerous missions against the enemies of mankind.